Alright, here it is, folks. The toilet I've been bragging about, I snagged last Friday, again, along the roadside, way over in Bayou Pigeon. And, it's a 64, and you tell me, man. It looks, I'm flushing out all the muck in it, because I'll give a demo flush here in a minute. But before I do, I'm up against a few things. So I'm going to just try the best I can to demonstrate. There's its partner right there with no name. 63. This one's a 63 because it says 63 and it says Borg Warner. The other one doesn't and it's a 1964. Now you tell me. I think the 64 is a little square down here on the bottom of the rim. Maybe this is too. But I can't tell. You know, the back is just totally gone off of this 64 I showed you in the other video. But this one is too. That's probably why they got rid of it. They were probably pulling up their floor or something in the house and it broke the mounting bolt back there. I had to elevate it up. I gave it a flush earlier and it's a swirly flush. Rim jets go that point, you know. It's not as straight like a Compton. I put a surplus handle on it, flush lever from that color I had. I took a surplus Flowmaster and put it in there, but I accidentally broke the, my bad, that. But the tank's in great shape, man. But God dang, man, this is such a frustrating disappointment right here. This trapway looks identical to this 64 one here. So, I'm pretty confident that that's a Borg Warner as well as this. Mystery solved, man. Alright, let me finish flushing it out, and I shall give us a long-awaited demo. And also note that I have a mismatched tank lid for it. It was found beside this one right here. Look, wasp made its way in there. And, it was found with the broken tank alongside with this bowl here, and it doesn't quite match up, so I don't think it's the same tank. I guess they just, a long time ago, the top of it may have broken, and they replaced it with that. Well, if the shoe fits, almost wear it. Okay, here we go with a trial run. By ear, by rag. It was all right. Although I'm trying to bet I have it on level ground here. How about a encore? Okay, how about a replay? And this time it's right above the water line. I got my thing in there via rag until I get that another. I don't know if I'll ever be able to restore this. But here we go again. Pretty quiet flush this time. How about a double whammy? Come on, give me a double whammy. It doesn't want to give me a double whammy. Remember, there's no flapper on it. The rag was the flapper. Pretty cool killer toilet. God dang, I wish it was in one piece. It's so upsetting, man. Love to have this masterpiece at my house. It's a rare find. Borg Warner from 1963. There it is right there. I do believe that's a 63. Well, guys, another downer. You can just go ahead and call me Tim the Toilet Man Taylor. Because the reason why I have it put up now, I put everything up to go into hibernation maybe. Remember, I put the rag over it as a plunger, so I would give a demo flush here. Oops, and guess what? The damn right. The rat got caught in a siphon jet. I was trying to pull it out the hard way, and there's no way of getting it out. Well, one good thing, no mud divers will get in there for the season. Damn, what did it slam against here? Oh, call me clumsy. Well, as I said, no mud divers will get in there and really clog it up. Here's my 67 Elger in hibernation and 63 Tepco or Trenton Potteries. And underneath there, right here, is my 1960 Trylon. Bad luck's just happened to me everywhere, folks. It's happening everywhere. Got church. My shades break. Everything breaks. Thanks for watching. Till next time.